Back in the day, the great Pele called Robson de Souza, or simply Robinho, his successor in football, but now the former Brazilian national striker has been thrown in jail. Recently, Robinho was arrested by the federal police at his home on the coast of São Paulo. At the request of the Italian authorities, the country's Supreme Court sentenced him to 9 years of jail time for the notorious scandal involving an Albanian woman in a Milan nightclub in 2013. The convicted Robinho is already being kept in prison and will be facing difficult and long ordeals, because Brazilian prisons are known for their terrible, sometimes even inhumane conditions and treatment. According to statistics and the latest Institute for Crime and Justice Policy Research report, as of June 2023, 835,643 people were imprisoned in Brazil. For every 100,000 citizens, there are 389 prisoners. Perhaps the most important problem of local prisons lies in overcrowding. Robinho will be placed with inmates into cells designed for one person, and every inch of available space will be filled faster than he can take a single breath. Soon he will find himself in a reality where prisoners are squeezed together in a tight space and have no choice but to sleep on the floor or in makeshift hammocks or near toilets that are basically just holes in the floor. However, even worse are the conditions in the disciplinary cells, designed to hold prisoners who need protection from other inmates. Well, Robinho is better off not getting there, because everyone who ends up in the yellow sections will be completely isolated from nature. They will be beaten by guards. Their water may be taken away for the whole day, and they will not see the sunlight at all. Because of this, their skin will turn yellow sooner or later. That's why prisoners who are condemned to such suffering are called yellow prisoners. And that's still far from over. Robinho also needs to take into account that the overcrowding in Brazilian prisons leads to pollution, poor sanitation, ventilation issues and diseases like AIDS and tuberculosis spreading like an epidemic. Drauzio Varela, a doctor who studies and writes books on the health needs of Brazilian prisoners, regularly encounters a disproportionate number of prisoners with serious health conditions, including diabetes, obesity, and hypertension. Robinho's challenge to survive could be further complicated by harsh punishments, intergroup warfare from within the facility, not to mention generally low government funding, which has caused Brazilian prison conditions to deteriorate year after year. The international human rights organization Human Rights Watch informs that due to the lack of funds, some Brazilian jails are literally crumbling down thanks to the brittle concrete as well as damaged plumbing and electrical systems. Sometimes there are even leaks in the roof. Yet the staff do nothing to solve the problem, simply ignoring the complaints of prisoners who have to fix everything on their own. In Brazil, the treatment of prisoners is at an all-time low, which brings us to another risk to Robson de Souza's life. This can be confirmed by the key holders, dangerous groups that conspire with prison guards to obtain key to cells and then either abuse or exploit vulnerable prisoners for their own purposes. That said, prisoner riots and clashes with guards are very common too. Hit the like button if you are as shocked by these conditions as we are, and let's continue. Robinho will serve his sentence in Tremembe Penitentiary, located about 150 kilometers from the city of São Paulo. It holds about 430 inmates. Based on the latest info from local media, the former footballer has already spent his first days there. Similar to other prisoners, Robinho's hair was cut and the guy was given a set of prison uniform, a toothbrush, toothpaste, shampoo, a cup, and a spoon. He is currently being held in a special solitary confinement cell that measures 8 square meters. He has a bed, a toilet, and a wash basin at his disposal. He is fed 3 or 4 times a day. The first meal is at 6 a.m. and the last one is at 5:30 p.m. Robinho will be kept in an individual cell for another 1 or 2 weeks in order to get him accustomed to prison life and provide safety as a new arrival. During this time, he will be isolated from other prisoners even during rest breaks, when all of them are allowed to go outside. The former football star will remain under the supervision of guards, doctors, psychologists, and social workers, though once the adaptation phase is complete, he will be transferred to a cell containing 4 to 5 people. Some kind of a special pavilion where prisoners are held for crimes with nationwide impact. For example, the case of one of Pele's sons, Edson Colby de Nascimento, who was caught laundering money, or the former Brazilian physician Roger Abdelmassi, who was sentenced to 173 years for sexually abusing 37 female patients. In Tremembe, there is a clear line between ordinary prisoners and special ones, who are treated more gently. The former, such as Robinho, are not allowed to leave the facility. They must stay on site full-time, while the latter are allowed to leave the place with a mandatory return in the evening. By order of the São Paulo state government, the largest and most comfortable cells can only hold a total of 6 prisoners in the whole of Tremembe, but it's not hard to understand that Robinho hasn't earned a place in the group of the lucky ones yet. Despite his celebrity status, the former Real Madrid attacker will have to work hard just like everyone else. Robinho is going to be involved in the production and repair of school desks and chairs, and also the production of tables for toilet cleaning. These are the types of work that Tremembe prison is well known for. Luckily, things are not so hopeless for Robinho. The prison has built football pitches, where he will be able to keep himself in shape. There is also an ecumenical room, a library, and other activities. You can attend workshops related to reading, origami, and drama. Visitors are allowed on weekends. Nevertheless, Robinho should really be concerned about only one question: how can he be released sooner without losing all 9 years of his life behind bars? And is it possible for him to turn things around in the same way as Dani Alves did? Brazilian criminal law states that convicts like Robinho can possibly get a more flexible sentence for their good behavior. In 2027, the footballer will be granted his right after serving almost half of his sentence, although not everyone will be happy about that. Outraged by the latest release of Dani Alves, Palmeiras president and head of Brazil's men's national team delegation, Leila Pereira, spoke out against any concessions of Robinho in an interview with the UOL web publication. "Nobody says anything, but I have to take a position on the cases of Robinho and Daniel Alves. This is a slap in the face to all women, especially the case of Daniel Alves, who paid for his freedom. I think it's important for me to take a stand. Each case of impunity is the seed of the next crime," Pereira notes. Robinho was also condemned by the president of the Brazilian Football Confederation, Ednaldo Rodrigues. "The definitive convictions of players Robson de Souza and Daniel Alves put an end to one of the most harmful chapters in Brazilian football. The yellow shirt that Brazilian athletes wear in the field is more than just a uniform, just as football is more than just a sport for Brazil. It's shameful that an athlete feels comfortable committing this type of perversity, believing that what he achieved through sport will somehow shield him from any punishment. Everyone needs to pay for what they committed." Let's face it, Brazilian society will certainly debate Robinho's moral qualities for quite some time, but we can only add that it's hard to find a sadder example of a player's downfall in the number one game. From being one of the leaders of Real Madrid and the Brazilian national team, as well as the most expensive newcomer of the English Premier League in 2008, to a prison cell and a ruined life. At least the next generations of Brazilian footballers will learn lessons from Robinho's story and how not to handle their careers. Guys, let us know in the comments below, how do you feel about Robinho and whether you believe in his return to freedom, the way Dani Alves did. Also, don't forget to give a like to this video and subscribe to our channel. Inside Football, we watch football from a different angle. Have a nice one, and see you in a bit!